Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. We are back with a new video. If you like our content, please like the video and do share it. So let us start with the first news. The Indian Army has asked its personnel to delete 89 mobile applications which would be including Facebook, Instagram, PUBG, Zoom, TikTok, Snapchat, ShareIt, dating apps like Tinder, Bumble, etc. This decision was taken by the Indian Army because there were reports of leakage of information within these apps, according to Indian Army sources. Also, recently the government of India has banned 59 Chinese origin apps, but the Indian Army ban includes some of the apps which were not of Chinese origin. The list of the apps which are banned by the Indian Army has been made public, and this list includes different categories like messaging platforms, video hosting apps, content sharing apps, web browsers, video streaming apps, games, e-commerce apps, etc. This list includes some of the major performing apps which were not banned by the government of India, which banned 59 Chinese origin apps. So some of these major apps includes Zoom, Facebook, gaming apps like PUBG, the social media apps like Facebook and Instagram. Also, the list includes some of the music apps, knowledge apps, news applications and microblogging application like Tumblr, Reddit, etc. The US government, led by President Donald Trump, has formally notified United Nations of its decision to withdraw from the World Health Organization, an arm of United Nations in the field of global public health. The United States government had earlier accused of the World Health Organization of siding China on the virus outbreak which was originated in the Chinese city Wuhan. As per the United States, the WHO has misled the world regarding the information of the coronavirus outbreak in China. Also, the President of United States, Donald Trump, made number of claims on the World Health Organization of siding China. So let us go through the claims from the side of US and from the side of WHO. The first claim was made by Donald Trump on May 18 when he wrote a letter to the chief of WHO, Dr. Tedros Adhanom, in which he stated that the WHO have consistently ignored reports of the coronavirus outbreak in the early December 2019 from some media sources like Lancet and some sources from other countries. On this, the editor of Lancet, Richard Horton, in a written response has said that the Lancet did not publish any report of the virus in early December 2019, but the first reports were published on January 24, 2020. From the side of WHO, it says that it was told by China of a pneumonia of an unknown cause on 31st December 2019. Further, on 12th January, China publicly shared the genetic sequence for the new coronavirus that had infected many people in the Wuhan province of China. And so, after that, a WHO team visited Wuhan and discussed about the outbreak with the Chinese leaders as well as the scientists, and by the end of January, the WHO had declared a public health emergency of a global concern. The claim number 2. President Donald Trump accused WHO that it parroted a wrong idea that there was no human-to-human transmission despite having evidence of it. In the middle of January, from the side of WHO, the World Health Organization tweeted on January 14th that preliminary investigations conducted by the Chinese authorities have found no clear evidence of human-to-human transmission of the novel coronavirus. But on the same day, the head of WHO's Emerging Disease Unit, Maria Van Kerkhove, appeared to contradict this statement by WHO, suggesting the journalist that there was limited human-to-human transmission observed within Wuhan, and it wasn't until 22 January that the WHO confirmed that there was clear evidence of human-to-human transmission in Wuhan. The third claim made by President Donald Trump on the WHO is that the WHO has always favored China and it did not pass any information of the coronavirus outbreak from China to the rest of the world. And since then, he has been making this claim till date. The claim number 4. The President Donald Trump claimed that one of the most dangerous decisions that came from WHO was to oppose the travel restrictions which were imposed by US on China. The US government restricted travel from China and other countries from 2 February. But on this claim, there is no record of WHO publicly criticizing this move. But obviously, the WHO on January 10th had put out advice recommending no international travel restrictions in response to the virus. So this was the claim made by President Donald Trump on the WHO. And now there is an official way where the US government can formally pull out of the WHO organization, in which a joint resolution was passed in 1948 between United States and the World Health Organization that if the US wants to pull out of the WHO, then it would have a time of 1 year notice period. So officially, the withdrawal of US from WHO will come into effect on July 6th or 7th, 2021. This is, of course, the official process of withdrawal from the WHO, but I don't think Donald Trump would follow any official procedures now. During the notice period of 1 year till 2021, the United States can rejoin WHO. So, amid this, the Democratic Party candidate Joe Biden has announced that if he is elected as the president in November 2020 election, then the US government will rejoin the WHO. The United States is currently the largest contributor to the fund of World Health Organization, contributing $450 million in the last year. US contributes about 15% of its annual budget in the WHO fund. Moving on towards the third update, Odisha becomes the first state in India to use space technology and artificial intelligence for safeguarding government lands. How? On July 8th, the Chief Minister of Odisha, Naveen Patnaik, launched Bluis, a web-based and mobile-based application which is Bhubaneswar Land Use Intelligence System. This Bluis system is a geo-tagged repository that would monitor and detect all the government lands in Bhubaneswar, and this will be done by using high-resolution satellite imagery.
Bhubaneswar is one of the fastest growing cities in India, witnessing land use changes on a daily basis. And in this process, precious public land is prone to encroachment. And to prevent that, the Odisha government will use the space technology to counter it. Also, because the present mechanism of detection and enforcement lacks the adequate transparency and accountability. This system would also include a mobile application which would alert the enforcement authorities of any new construction on the government lands in Bhubaneswar. The GPS on the application will guide the enforcement staff to the exact location where any type of construction is done. And as a part of evidence, a photo which would be taken by the Bluis would be uploaded to the application. So this is a new and a transparent way to keep watch on the government lands. On the morning of 9th July, the famous gangster and history cheater Vikas Dubey was arrested from Ujjain near the Mahakaleshwar temple. The UP police had been searching for Vikas Dubey and the men who were aiding him after 8 policemen were killed during an attempted arrest of Vikas Dubey. Vikas Dubey is a history cheater who is based in the Kanpur district of the Uttar Pradesh. The first case against him was registered in the early 1990 until date 60 criminal cases are registered against him. So now the police will conduct the investigation against him and register the appropriate case which would be filed against Vikas Dubey. Moving on towards our last update. The activities of international cricket has resumed with the test match of England and West Indies. This would be the first international cricket match that would be played after the suspension of sports due to the coronavirus pandemic. The last international cricket match that was played on March 13 was between Australia and New Zealand. And due to the coronavirus pandemic, all the sports activities around the world were suspended. When the West Indies team arrived in the United Kingdom, they quarantined themselves for 14 days in Manchester. And for the entire tour, the two teams will train and play in a biosecure environment as a part of comprehensive medical plans to ensure the safety of the players. Also, the match will be played with no crowd. And this would be the first match to be played without crowd in 143 years long history of cricket. Talking about other sports, the German Football League Bundesliga was the world's first major football tournament to resume its operation post-COVID-19. The organizers of the tournament decided to go ahead with the matches with no live audience and keeping all the protocols in check to ensure the safety of all the players. And after that, other major football leagues like La Liga and Premier League also made comeback. Formula 1 has also resumed its season with the Austrian Grand Prix. So this is it for today. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel to get the regular updates from our channel.